This is Tyson here. We're going to take an assessment today. So let's start with prayer and then we'll dive into our assessment. Just a reminder that we're praying for Christians in these restricted and hostile areas in Ethiopia. That's our new country that we're praying for people in, Nigeria and India. All right, let's pray also for these scholars in fifth and these scholars in sixth. Please pause the video and pray for those people. Okay, thanks. Today we are on lesson 27. You're going to take an assessment today for most of the class. Let's dive in quickly. Just want to give a shout out to Wisconsin. Look at all these yellow and green homework colors. That means you guys are doing a great job turning in your work. If your class has red, take a look at the last slide. I'm going to show you if you're somebody who's missing an assignment so that you can work on it when you're done with your quiz. Book of Mark, here's our verse. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. You're going to need to know that for your quiz. Thanks for bringing in shoeboxes. Keep bringing them in. Reminder on your quiz today, please don't write things like this. N-A, I wasn't here today. I don't have my notes. Don't write those in your answers. If you do, you'll get them marked wrong. And this is a quiz. It's worth almost half of your grade. Okay? Here is your prop for today. It'll also be in your quiz. What motivated Jesus to react the way he did to the money changers in the temple? I'm going to read it again. What motivated Jesus to react the way he did to the money changers in the temple? This is why we study the Word of God, because a close examination leads to a deeper understanding. You'll need to know these steps of Bible study for today's quiz. Make sure you're not looking back in your notes. This is not an open notes quiz. When you get to the application, I've given you a scripture. You're going to write gospel truth, which is who is Jesus and what did he do. If you're wondering how to do this part, look right up here. The question right here is for you. If you answer this question down here, you'll have done it correctly. And then answer this question, how should I respond to the gospel? Make sure you're specific, something you can do today. Remember, we're studying in the place called Palestine. That's where our book of Mark takes place. Here's our text for today. Go ahead and pause the video and read it together, and then we're going to watch the video about this. Okay, here's the video clip.
The next day, as they were leaving Bethany, Jesus was hungry. Seeing in the distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to find out if it had any fruit. When he reached it, he found nothing but leaves, because it was not the season for figs. Then he said to the tree, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again." And his disciples heard him say it. On reaching Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple courts. He began driving out those who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves, and would not allow anyone to carry merchandise through the temple courts. And as he taught them, he said, "Is it not written, 'My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations'? But you have made it a den of robbers." The chief priests and the teachers of the law heard this and began looking for a way to kill him, for they feared him, because the whole crowd was amazed at his teaching. When evening came, Jesus and his disciples went out of the city. In the morning, as they went along, they saw the fig tree withered from the roots. Peter remembered and said to Jesus, "Rabbi, look, the fig tree you cursed has withered." "Have faith in God," Jesus answered. "Truly, I tell you, If anyone says to this mountain, go, throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in their heart, but believes that what they say will happen, it will be done for them. Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins.
Ladies and gentlemen, that part about the fig tree is not in our text back here. I wanted to include it though. The point is that just like the fig tree didn't bear fruit and so was destroyed, so when people aren't really Christians, when they're not really God's children and they're all just about themselves and they don't really love God and they don't really believe that God is their Father, they won't bear fruit. And then one day judgment will come and they will be destroyed too. So I just wanted to show you that because it's an important part of the passage. Right now you're going to go ahead and complete your packet. Ladies and gentlemen, on your exit ticket, I did not include these four things, so you can start right away with the retell, and then you're going to do your race, and then this is the commentary. It's also in your notes. You need to find a fact from this text. Some of you are just copying down a literal verse, like you're just taking one of these verses to put it right here in this information piece. That's not the right thing to do. Use a fact from this commentary. So read it, say, oh, I didn't know that, and then write that fact right here. I'm only going to have you do one again. Then you're going to write a theological principle. That's a true fact that's universal about God from the text. Finally, I gave you the verse, the scripture. You just need to write a gospel truth and a gospel in action, okay? Guys, for the rest of class, you need to work quietly. When you're done with your exit ticket, I'm going to actually ask the teacher if they'll leave this up on the board. This tells you if, this tells you what your missing assignments are, how many you have, all right? Scholars, have a great rest of the day. Get this done so it doesn't become missing assignment, okay? Work, work, work.